Right now, there's a star hurtling through the Milky Way that could vaporize human atoms in an instant, turning you into a cloud of plasma, a mist of human soup. Maybe there's time for a millisecond-long scream, and then you're gone. Just space fog. Well, maybe not. We don't really know what you'd look like. But we do know scientists are calling this cosmic killer the zombie star, and the bad news is they don't know where it came from or what it's planning. Sure, calling it a zombie star is fun, but astronomers prefer its formal name, SGR-0501+4516. It is tearing through the galaxy at over 110,000 miles per hour, and it's heading in our direction. It's effectively an out-of-control cosmic cannonball that could lead to us all having a very bad day. According to NASA, the leading theory is that this cosmic menace is a magnetar, a massive neutron star with a magnetic field so intense it could wipe your credit card from orbit. In space, there are stars way bigger than our own sun, that flaming furnace responsible for both life on our Earth and overpriced sunblock. Sunburn is a sacrifice we can live with, though, because if our own sun stopped burning, everything would get very dark, and, well, we would have a really difficult time down here. Thankfully, there's no way it'll just go out. Stars take billions of years to power down. Even if it did just go out, it takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach us, so we wouldn't notice right away. We'd still have some leftover heat trapped in Earth's atmosphere, but it wouldn't last that long. Within days, things would get noticeably colder, and to give it a year, the average global temperatures would plummet to around negative 100 degrees Fahrenheit. That is brutal weather, even for Canadians. When massive stars run out of fuel, and they all will, gravity wins and they explode in what's called a supernova. The core collapses in on itself, and the outer parts are ejected violently into space. What's left in that core is incredibly dense. That core is made almost entirely of neutrons, hence it's called a neutron star. They have crazy strong magnetic fields, but in rare, extreme conditions, a neutron star can become a magnetar, a kind of exotic star whose magnetic field is, frankly, ridiculous. It's about 1,000 to 10,000 times stronger than a neutron star's and trillions of times stronger than the Earth's. Suffice it to say that if you got anywhere near one, sunblock wouldn't save you. Nothing would. That's why they scare even seasoned astronomers. After black holes, magnetars are the densest known objects in the universe. But if black holes are also the remains of dead stars, what's the difference? Well, it all comes down to size. Stars around 10 to 25 times the mass of our sun usually collapse into a neutron star when they die, and in rare cases they become magnetars. But when stars are even bigger, say over 25 to 30 times the mass of our sun, size really starts doing weird things. It is these giants that can collapse into black holes. Instead of leaving behind a neutron star with a solid crust and a crazy magnetic field, the collapse goes all the way down, past any physical surface into what we call a singularity. This is the point of infinite density, where even light can't escape, and space-time itself breaks down. So, black holes are obviously very different from supermagnetic, mind-blowingly dense stars with an actual physical core. That core might only be small, say the size of a city. But let's remember, there is a huge star packed into it, a star that used to be millions of times bigger than the Earth. Okay, so now we've got that straightened out. What are these magnetars up to these days? In 2004, the Earth got a cosmic blast from one of those stars that partially ionized the upper atmosphere. It blinded satellites, it caused an eruption that scientists called a star quake. In short, it set off a lot of alarms, but it made astronomers very excited. It was also slightly worrying, but since it was 50,000 light-years away, it was never going to cause much damage. But if it had been much closer, well, we'll get to that soon. But it was in 2008 that the space agencies noticed SGR-0501+4516, aka the zombie star. To know such a thing exists, scientists studied what they called outbursts and emissions. It's not like these stars introduced themselves with their magnetic personalities. By studying the bursts, they definitely knew they had something unique on their hands. They can't say exactly how strong this one's magnetic field is, but the ballpark figure is 100 trillion times more powerful than the Earth's. Now that is pretty scary. But thankfully, it was at a safe distance of 15,000 light-years away. Still, in cosmological terms, that is pretty much the same as living down the street. But in human terms, it's quite far, 88.2 quadrillion miles. Now, if that's confusing, 1 quadrillion is a million billion. So this zombie star wasn't exactly knocking on our front door. But if it is far away, what's with NASA's doom spiel about people being turned into plasma? Well, first off, SGR-0501+4516 seemed to come out of nowhere. And in the space game, that can come as a shock. What if other things spring up seemingly out of nowhere? Big surprises in space could mean human extinction one day. Secondly, it wasn't acting like anything they'd previously seen. As we said before, it was moving really fast and in a direction that didn't make any sense. And thirdly, NASA said if this gamma-ray-toting gangster of the universe did do a drive-by on the Earth, and by that the agency meant coming as close as half the distance of the Moon, it would create the biggest mess the Earth has ever seen. It would make the Permian-Triassic extinction, aka the Great Dying, look like a light rain shower. It wouldn't just fry a few satellites, it would result in a mass extinction. We would all die. NASA, in full apocalyptic preacher mode, explained, if a human got within 600 miles, the magnetar would become a proverbial sci-fi death ray, ripping apart every atom inside the body. So, yeah, a date with the zombie star would be pretty annoying. We'd all just dissolve, kind of like dematerialization in Star Trek, except there would be no transmission and rematerialization on some weird planet. We would beam up, but not beam down. Okay, so what are the chances of this actually happening? And where did this intergalactic assassin come from? Remember, SGR0501 plus 4516 isn't acting like anything else we've seen. So right now, there's a lot of theory, but we still need more data to be sure. We do know that it is moving too fast and heading the wrong direction for it to have come from one of the massive star supernova we told you about. Scientists initially thought that this must have come from the 2,000 light-years away galactic supernova remnant HB9. But no, it didn't. NASA tracked its trajectory and it just doesn't add up. SGR0501 plus 4516 just kinda showed up out of nowhere, and it was running faster than anything scientists had ever seen. But here is the key thing. Most magnetars come from supernovae, those big explosions of massive stars. But in this case, scientists are now saying, what if this one was made differently? What if this magnetar formed not from supernova, but from a white dwarf that collapsed inward? Okay, so what's a white dwarf? Let's say a smaller star, like our Sun, burns through its fuel and hits retirement age. It starts to puff out its outer layers, creating what we call a planetary nebula, like a cosmic fart cloud. The core left behind is a white dwarf, a relatively small, dim, ultra-dense ember that can smolder for billions of years. Now, when we say dense, you really wouldn't want a bit to hit you in the head. As ridiculous as it sounds, just a teaspoon of white dwarf matter could weigh over 5 tons, about the weight of an elephant. Space is weird. Normally, if a white dwarf gains too much weight by stealing mass from a companion star, it goes nuclear, it hits critical mass, and it blows up in what's called a Type 1A supernova. This isn't the same supernova as from a massive star. When this happens, there's nothing left behind. Not a neutron star, not a magnetar, just something like space confetti. But instead of exploding, a white dwarf might just collapse in on itself, skipping the boom and going straight to neutron star mode. That's called accretion-induced collapse, and in really rare cases, the result isn't just a neutron star, but a magnetar. Yeah, you're confused. So are we. Unfortunately, Neil deGrasse Tyson wasn't available to give us the Space for Dummies explanation, but actually it's not all that complicated. Basically, rather than the leftovers from a massive star supernova, the cosmic zombie could be the leftovers from a small star, a collapsed white dwarf, without the supernova boom. That doesn't make it any less dangerous, though. There are only 30 known magnetars in our galaxy, but scientists suspect there could be more. They only stay active for about 10,000 years, and then they retire. It's thought that there could be 30 million boomer zombie stars lurking around on cosmic walkers, quietly minding their own business, too old to do too much damage. But some of the active ones are pretty close to us. Well, again, in cosmological terms, just bear in mind there are an estimated 2 trillion galaxies in the 93 billion light-years of the observable universe. Humans tend to overlook the fact that we are spinning around in something magical and mysterious. Anyway, in 2018, the magnetar XTEJ1810-197 had an outburst, and that one's only 8,000 light-years away. Another one, SGR1900+14, is 20,000 light-years off in the Aquila constellation. SGR1806-20 is 50,000 light-years away. And then there's SGR0526-66, the only confirmed one not in our galaxy. In 1979, it went off and overwhelmed US and Soviet satellites, resulting in the most intense gamma-ray burst we've ever recorded. But down here on Earth, Dallas and the Dukes of Hazzard were not interrupted, so no one really cared. Back to the zombie again. We still don't know why it's giving off fast radio bursts or why it's moving like a cosmic pinball without a visible source. It's acting more like a rogue particle than a dead star, and we just don't know why. Now obviously, If we're all going to get vaporized one day, it would be great if we got a heads up. Because, you know, there's stuff we need to get done. For one thing, you still got those vouchers for Disney World's 18-hole mini-golf adventure that your aunt got you for Christmas. But the likelihood of a zombie star making up 88 quadrillion miles and causing a mass extinction is extremely unlikely. Even at a nippy 110,000 miles per hour, it would still take hundreds of thousands of years to get remotely close to us. Even then, the gravity would always be getting in the way and messing with the trajectory, and of course, it would have powered down by then, if it is what we think it is. So yes, the zombie star might have what NASA calls comic book hero superpowers, but when it comes to your 2025 hierarchy of fears, that is still pretty low on the list. Now you need to watch Scientists Just Revealed the Universe Does Not Exist. Here's the proof. Or have a look at Apollo 13 Space Mission Disaster, Hour by Hour.